Everyone, welcome to the Back to Basics series. So this lecture is a comprehensive yet crisp imaging overview of ankylosing spondylitis. Ankylosing spondylitis is also less commonly known as Becketrau disease and Mayri-Strumpel disease. It's a seronegative spondyloarthropathy. Ankylosis means fusion, so it refers to the involvement and eventual fusion of the spine and sacroiliac joints. ESR is raised and HLA-B27 antigen is seen. AS has a male predilection. Coming to the pathological features, enthesis is where a tendon or a ligament meets the bone. So a disorder of the enthesis, that is enthesopathy, can incorporate tendinopathy, bursitis, cyst-like erosions, calcifications, enthesophytes, and osteitis. Now, loss of the normal joint space secondary to inflammatory erosions and pseudo-widening, resulting in ankylosis, is another feature. So now we have concerns at the synovial articulations, cartilage articulations, and enthesopathy, or the enthesis. So enthesis is where a tendon and a ligament meet the bone. So here at the enthesis, we have a finding, which is whiskering. So whiskering at the enthesis is an irregular bony growth in the form of bony spicules. Coming to the synovial articulations, there will be synovial proliferation, pannus formation, subchondral bone erosions, leading to intraarticular osseous ankylosis. Coming to the cartilage articulations, osteitis results in fibrous tissue replacing the bone and cartilage, forming trabeculae in the joint, finally leading to ankylosis. Nothing better than picking up a joint disease in the early stages. So what are the early radiological changes that we see in AS? One is syndesmophytes. So syndesmophytes is the annulus fibrosis and ligamentous ossification resulting in segmental ankylosis. An apophysis is a normal secondary ossification center that is located in the non-weight-bearing part of the bone, and it eventually fuses. So what we see here in AS is apophyseal joint erosions. Also, there will be findings of atlantoaxial instability, lumbar hyperlordosis. Now we have the rominous lesions, shiny corner sign, and vertebral squaring that we see in the early features of AS. So there is irregularities and erosions involving the anterior and posterior edges of the vertebral end plates, resulting in inflammation appearing as rominous lesions in MRI. The healing process and reactive sclerosis appears as a shiny corner sign, and loss of the normal anterior vertebral body concavity results in vertebral squaring. What are the late changes that we see in AS? One is discal ballooning. We also see barrel vertebra and another finding called the railroad or the trolley track spine. So discal ballooning is what happens when there are osteoporotic vertebral bodies which cause end plate biconcavity, and because of the mechanical effect on nucleus pulposus, that causes discal ballooning. Barrel vertebra is what happens when there's resorption of the anterosuperior and inferior vertebral body margins, causing mid-vertebral body osteitis, convexity of the anterior vertebral body, causing a barrel vertebra. We have the railroad of the trolley track spine, where there is ossification of the joint capsule, ligamentum flavum, and interspinous ligaments, causing linear radiodense opacities. Then we have the famous dagger spine and the bamboo or the poker spine that we see in ankylosing spondylitis. So dagger spine is the cause of the ossification of supraspinatus and infraspinatus ligaments. It appears as a vertical midline linear radiodense opacity connecting all the lumbar processes. Ossification of the outer fibers of annulus fibrosis, formation of marginal syndesmophytes, and bridging and bulging of the intervertebral disc spaces is what causes the bamboo spine. There are Anderson lesions that we see in the late AS, which refers to an inflammatory involvement of the intervertebral discs by spondyloarthritis, which basically appears stir hyperintense on MR imaging. We have other signs like the ghost joint, which is the articular cortex visualization through an ankylosed joint. We see the star sign in the SI joints, which is basically a triangular radio opacity because of the ossification of the superior sacroiliac ligaments. We also see carrot or chalk stick fractures in AS where the ankylosed segment is fractured. There's a rosary bead appearance that we see again in the SI joints. This is owing to the joint erosions because of the undulating appearance of the sacroiliac articular margins. Other findings that we see in the late AS in radiology is the loss of joint space, enthesopathy, whiskering, osteoporosis, peripheral joint involvement, postural changes, and vertebral body atrophy. The skeletal changes in AS involving the clavicle would be the distal clavicular erosions. In shoulders, we see the hatchet deformity, which is erosion in the anterolateral aspect of the humeral head. In hands, there is periostitis, which is marginal, along with findings of erosions. Knee joint would give findings which overlap with osteoarthritis in the form of decreased knee joint space, bony proliferation, and joint effusions. Calcaneum shows erosions, osteoporosis, and periostitis, predominantly in the regions of posterior Achilles and plantar aponeurosis. Chest pain could be because of the involvement of costochondral and manubriosternal joint involvement. Costovertebral joints are also involved with similar findings like in the rest of the joints, like that of erosions, sclerosis, and loss of joint space. In the pelvis, specifically, we see fusion and bridging of the pubic symphysis. The hips show osteophytes and subchondral cysts, predominantly at the femoral head and the neck junction, joint space narrowing, which is uniform, and findings of protrusio acetabuli, which is the axial migration of the femoral head. In the cervical spine, which is more specific is the arachnoid dilatation due to the increased diameter of the intravertebral foramen. Another finding is the temporomandibular joint involvement, which often parallels the appearance of changes in the cervical spine. Another sign that we see is the shiny odontoid sign, which is basically the increased density of the odontoid process in the cervical spine imaging. Also, we see atlantoaxial instability and odontoid erosions in the cervical spine imaging in patients with AS. Coming to the sacroiliac joints, these are the most commonly and early involved joints in ankylosing spondylitis. The early changes that we see in SI joints are loss of bony margins, loss of joint space, pseudo-widening of the SI joints, subchondral erosions, which is the rosary bead sign. Then we see sclerosis and subchondral osteoporosis. The late features would be ankylosis, loss of sclerosis, osteoporosis, and the ghost sign, where we're seeing the SI joint corticular margin and ossification of the ligamentous portion of the joints, which is the star sign. Coming to the multi-system involvement in patients with AS, chest manifestations, we could radiologically pick up findings of interstitial lung changes, apical fibrosis, emphysema, bronchiectasis, and micronodules. In the kidneys, they could be associated with glomerulonephritis, renal amyloidosis, and nephropathy. In the skin, they could be presenting with psoriasis. In the eyes, they could have findings of iritis and uveitis. In the muscular manifestations, they could come with paraspinal muscle spasms, contractures, and atrophy. In cardiac manifestations, they predominantly present with myocardial fibrosis. Gastrointestinal manifestations, they predominantly present with IBDs, Crohn's disease, and ulcerative colitis. Prostate, they come with presenting complaints of chronic prostatitis. In the aorta, they present with aortitis. Coming to the signal change patterns in the intervertebral discs, they could be marginal, they could be annular, that is peripheral, they could be central, they could be homogeneously solid, or it can be a mixed signal intensity. Coming to the complications seen in patients with ankylosing spondylitis, one is that of fracture. So it could be a straight out fracture because of a diffuse paraspinal ossification resulting in inflammatory osteitis and a fused and brittle spine being exposed to trauma resulting in fracture. Or is what we've discussed earlier is a chalk stick or a carrot stick fracture where the bone is osteopenic. It has resulted in a deformity. In the setting of trauma, we have to search for the disc space widening and discontinuity of the ossified paraspinal ligaments, which basically results in a chalk stick or a carrot stick fracture. So arachnoid diverticula, most diverticulae are directed posteriorly. So in a long-standing pressure effect, it could erode the pedicles, lamina, and spinous processes. Dural ectasia and diverticulate formation appears closely linked to the development of cauda equina syndrome. And myelography should not be attempted in an ankylosed spine because it may lead to deterioration of the patient's condition. We've spoken about the Anderson's lesions, which is an inflammatory spondylodiscitis that occurs in association with AS, and it results in disc pseudoarthrosis. Neurological complications, one is cauda equina syndrome and the other is transverse myelitis. Other causes for cauda equina syndrome in a patient with AS could include post-irradiation ischemia, demyelination, and arachnoiditis. So there's an index called the Bath Ankylosing Spondylitis Disease Activity Index, which has, it's a 10-point scale. So a score of 4 or greater than that suggests AS. So coming to an imaging review, these are lateral and lateral radiographs of the cervical spine showing intervertebral disc calcifications, fusion of posterior elements, and ossification of the anterior longitudinal ligament. Here we can see the shiny odontoid sign appearing as an increased density in the region of the odontoid process. These are frontal and lateral radiographs of the cervical spine showing syndesmophytes. These are frontal and lateral radiographs of the spine showing the most commonly found feature, the dagger spine, the bamboo spine, and squaring of vertebral bodies. Lateral radiograph of the spine showing vertebral end plate sclerosis, vertebral body erosions in the corners, in decreased intervertebral disc space, and fusion of the posterior elements. Lateral and frontal radiographs of the spine showing the shiny corner sign, barrel-shaped vertebrae, discal ballooning because of the end plate concavities, and the railroad or the trolley track spine. Coming to the plain CT scan images of the cervical spine in sagittal, axial, and coronal planes in the bone window showing extensive ankylosis and decreased intervertebral disc spaces. So you can take a moment to look at the signs of ankylosing spondylitis in this whole spine MRI image. So what we see here are findings of the shiny corner sign, that is vertebral body corner sclerosis, decreased intervertebral disc space, vertebral body corner erosions called the Romanus lesions, vertebral end plate erosions, squaring of the vertebral bodies, syndesmophytes, and discovertebral instability, or otherwise known as Anderson's lesions. This is a magnified view of the same findings of shiny corner sign, vertebral end plate erosions, discovertebral instability, and the Romanus lesions. So these are CT sections, bone window, showing fusion of the costovertebral joints, syndesmophytes, vertebral body margin erosions, intervertebral disc calcifications, ossification of the interspinous ligament, ossification of the anterior longitudinal ligament, and fusion of the posterior elements. So this is a radiograph that is projecting the sacroiliac joints and showing two signs that we see in the SI joints in AS, that is the rosary bead sign and the star sign. So star sign is a triangular opacity, which is depicting the sacroiliac joint ligamentous ossification. The rosary bead sign shows the loss of bony margins and joint space, sclerosis, and mild ankylosis with fuzzy margins in the SI joints. This is a frontal radiograph of the pelvis showing sclerosis, hip joint space narrowing, and osteophytes with whiskering in the right hemipelvis. So these are findings that we again see in ankylosing spondylitis. Findings in the respiratory system that we can see in a patient with AS could be that of pleural thickening, emphysematous changes with bulle, bronchiectatic changes, micronodules, pleuroparenchymal bands, and fibrotic changes in bilateral upper lobes, predominantly in the apex.